Hi guys, welcome to the new town which I will be building here in Scrapping Attic. We're gonna start the town off with a fire station that I built and worked on for the last couple of days to get the build up and build around the city, and also the fire station with a fire truck. The fire truck will go up on the workshop, and yeah, let's get into it. Don't worry about that. That's maybe next episode if you're lucky. So it's all round build by of concrete. It's actually pretty big, or not huge, but big enough. Garage space, two trucks I think will fit in there. And here's the main entrance with some awesome sliding doors due to the pistons we got in the update for not so long ago. Lit up, automatic doors, and we get into the lobby. This is just the reception. You can come in and ask to speak to one of the firemen, or set up a meeting with someone higher up to get like information about fire. Fire prevention is called. So yeah. Just easy with the one screen. I didn't bother putting some keyboard down. Yeah, in here, this little room here, you have the 911 central. In our way, the 911 central usually is on the bigger. It's not the 911. It's a 110, like 110. It's the number for fire in Norway. So this is the 110 central. In Norway, they are not the dedicated central for emergency response. They are on the biggest like station, police station, hospitals, fire station in the region or city. Depends on. It's different from county to county. But yeah, this is the 110 central for this town. So here there can be three operators. They each have a computer and pretty standard. And then we can go to the next one, which is the bathroom with some toilets and some sinks. I did not fit a shower. I should maybe have done that, but yeah. Four sinks, two toilets, not the most impressive. In there we go later. We go down the hallway and up these stairs, and we get to the living room. Pretty bare, not much. There's a couch, some chairs, and you can actually sit in the couch, and there is a button connected to it. You can turn on the TV and watch on the cooking show. So yeah, I'm not gonna be here and listen to that. So yeah, this is the living room or entertainment room. Then you have the kitchen or an eating area with a pretty darn nice kitchen. This is done with mods, I have to say that. Both vehicles and buildings are built with a lot of mods. I will try to like make them on the workshop page for the truck to get all the mods that's needed for it. So yeah, kitchen with a coffee maker, sink, a stove, and a fan to pull up the fumes and everything from it. Big fridge that doesn't open, I'm sorry about that, and sitting area for 8 people. So yeah, and then you have the living quarters here. It's a bed and a nightstand. That's it for 4 people. That's all the people that work here. I'm planning of maybe putting another, like, for the guy that's is in charge of the team, either a chief or a lieutenant. Maybe get a bigger room over here in this area. It's some plan for next time. This bed is also mod, so we can lay in them. Looks pretty won't sleep, but oh well. And if we go, it's only force beds. And there is down here, it's a little pole that they're used to get down. In Norway, they're not used so much because of safety, and it's faster to run down the stairs. I don't know why they built it like that, but oh well. In here, there is a wardrobe. The wardrobe leads out to the garage area. Just some lockers. I know there is not a lot of details here, but I'm trying to be better by using small things. There you have the pole, and here is the fire truck with some nice reflection on the back. Oh well. Let's open the garage port. It's just the easy one due to reducing lag as much as I can. But with the new update that's coming out, it's in a test now. There will be not calculating collisions when they are turned off or turned completely on. Physics calculation will not be doing too much. So yeah, that's good. And the fire truck, I will just pull it out of here and onto this. So yeah, a fire truck, pretty basic. Based on a Scania fire truck, that's what we have the most of here in Norway. So yeah, it has lights, blue emergency lights and some other stuff. And on the back there is a, like this reflections area. It's on almost all, at least on the fire trucks and on the police cars. We have them with much reflexes on the rear, and some have on the side also, to be spotted easily if they don't have the emergency lights on. It's kind of tall, so you can get all over the place. And I have this like step out, because yeah, why not? And yeah, pretty basic truck. Not too much to talk about. Interior wise, it's actually pretty detailed. Again, a lot of mods used to get this like this, with a compartment that can be opened. Some fans. Actually some pedals. Just to make it. And yeah, that's horn. We have doors at 1. 2 is lights. 3 is the horn. 4 is small lights, like close or daytime running lights, that's what they called, at least. And 5 is the really bright headlights. So yeah, it drives pretty steadily, it's easy to tip over. Maybe I will put some heavier weight down in the bottom of this. Not the best at driving. Whoa. So yeah. Whoa. I know I'm not good at driving. Oh well. That has been for today's episode of This Town. Like, comment, subscribe, comment with the other things you want to see in the town. I plan to build a bus station. It will be coming up in the next one of the next episodes. It will be at this lot, but I will be expanding this town, and there will be a lot more buildings as far the game can handle it. I have gotten some suggestions. I will think about them. But leave down in the comments if you what you want to see. If there is something I can do better. doing these videos. I know I'm not good at English. I'm from Norway. That's kind of bad, I know. But yeah, like, comment, subscribe, all that shit. There is a Patreon link down below if you want to support me. And see you guys next time. Bye for now.